It's by the Sox, bottom of the fifth, tied at one. Darren Lewis, base is loaded, base hit, squeaks through up the middle. Trot Nixon, Scott Hatterberg come around to score. Red Sox take a 3-1 lead. We pick it up top six. Here's Pat Rapp striking out Troy Gloss to end the inning. Rapp was strong. He struck out only four batters. Bottom of the sixth, Donnie Sadler. Base hit to right center, Reggie Jefferson would score. Red Sox up 5-1, and they go on to win 7-4. We said Rapp only struck out four batters in six innings of work. Trot Nixon, three hits, scored three runs.
Warming up because John Burkett's in a jam, but then he gets Tony Bautista to get away. One out, Willie Green, right back at him. One, two, and three. It's a double play. Burkett escapes the first. He ends up going 6 2/3, allows just one run. Fourth inning, 1-0 the Jays. Runner at second, Rafael Palmeiro. Bueno. Palmeiro with a single, then misplayed by Jacob Brumfield. Juan Gonzalez coming to score. Palmeiro goes out to second. Breaks the club record for RBI in a month, 39. Next batter, Todd Zeal. It is back. It is back. It's not coming back. His 18th, not in this game. That would be a record. 4-2, the Blue Jays.
Dog days in Chicago. Bottom of the first, scoreless. Craig Wilson at the plate facing Kevin Apier. Loops it. Randy Velarde, nice grab. You know that feels good on the grass. No score after one. Bottom five, White Sox to the 3-2 lead. Base is loaded. Carlos Lee comes through. Magly Ordóñez scores. Paul Konerko scores, throw to third. Now where's the third baseman? Well, he's not at third base, that's for sure, and that allows Chris Singleton to score. White Sox take a 6-2 lead. Your next batter, say hi to Greg Norton. Nubber down the first baseline. Mike Oquist and Jason Giambi nearly collide, and Randy Velarde throws home. Carlos Lee beats the tag, and the White Sox win by a score of 7-2. Chicago reliever. Two looking to add to that with a runner on second when Jeff Kent lines a shot to center. But Brian Giles hanging out without his horse. And Giles ends the threat. Giles then leads off the next inning. How many times do you see it? And he takes Sean Estes deep and out. If it's fair, it's gone. Not even close. 31st of the year. Pirates within 5-3. And here we go. Tying run at the plate. Two out. Brant Brown facing Rob Nen. And Nen gets him. Nen strikes out the side in the ninth for his 30th save. He ties Mike Marshall for 31st.
On Tony Womack. He's fast. And he's stolen a base. Number 60. He leads the league. Two batters later, Luis Gonzalez taking it deep. Ricky Henderson and Darrell Hamilton. One of them will get it. Boat! This play was taped for training purposes. Womack scores on the ground rule double. One zip Diamondbacks. Mets trying to get back in it, down 4-2. Edgardo Alfonso into the vacancy. Henderson coming around to score. Mets within one. Third inning, 5-4 Diamondbacks. Roger Cedeño's on first. The pitch out, and he is meat. Gunned out by Kelly Stinnett. Cedeño's second in stolen bases to Womack. Two back. Luis Gonzalez. His 23rd of the season. 6-4 the Diamondbacks. And how did it finish? 8-4. Diamondbacks win this thing. Arizona first and third against Walt Weiss. Going deep to the wall. Andrew Jones will score on the relay. Edgar Renteria not in time to get Eddie Perez. Fancy slide. Makes it 2-0 Braves. Fourth inning. Loaded up. John Smoltz against Alberto Castillo. Blooping it. Mark McGuire going to come and score. 2-1. Braves in front. Now tied at two, they're in the sixth. Smoltz against Fernando Tatis, chopping broccoli. Next batter, Craig Paquette is choking on a splinter. Greg Maddux would watch Smoltz strike out seven. Seventh inning, 3-2 Braves. Smoltz to Joe McEwing off the bench. Had he been on the bench, that wouldn't have happened. Ninth of the year, 3-3 tie, cross rolled to the 12th. Chipper Jones off Juan Acevedo. He's going to get his name in the paper. 34th home run of the season. That ties his career high, and it is a game winner. The Braves getting it done 4-3 in 12 innings. Mark picked lineup out of a hat for those numbers outside of spots 3 through 6, which he did pick. The bottom of the lineup seemed to work for him. Top of two, no score. Two on, the eight hitter, Dan Wilson. 3-2 pitch from Andy Pettit, and it's going places. Two-run double. Edgar Martinez will come to score. Jay Buhner will score as well. Mariners up 2-0. Fifth inning, Mariners are down 3-2. The ninth batter, David Bell. And even with derogatory credit, you can own a brand new car. His 17th, Pinella's lineup working out. Bottom of five, New York up 4-3. Ricky Ledet to Ken Griffey. Almost had it. Now no one has it. The ball's bouncing away and stopped. Bernie Williams scores. Ledet still running. And inside the park, home run for Ledet. It's the 13th inside the park home run of the majors this season. The Yankees for the best record in the American League. Roberto Alomar to right center. Jose Guillen. Newbie! Drops between Guillen and Terry Lowry. Enar Diaz comes to score, ties it at two. And Guillen is puzzled. Bases loaded, 6-4 Devil Rays. Jim Thome against Roberto Hernandez. They're loaded, I say. And that's just another case of the man keeping us down. Cleveland left the bases loaded twice in the game. Devil Rays won it 6-4. Before being stopped in this one, Cleveland had won 18 games in final at-bats this year. Hernandez, 15 for 15.
Second, Todd at one. Marlins have the bases loaded, and Mike Hampton turns back. Alex Gonzalez gets him to hit into the 6-4-3 double play. Hampton out of the jam. Bottom of the sixth. Astros trailing 2-1. Jose Lima already has the rally cap on in the sixth inning, and it worked. Darryl Ward of Alex Fernandez. Fourth homer of the year. A three-run bomb made it 4-2 Astros. Top seven. It's 5-3 now. Marlins in second and third with nobody out, and Hampton against Gonzalez, gets him looking, one out. Then Bruce Abin swings and misses badly, strike three. Hampton would get out of that jam as well. They go on to win by a score of 10-4, good buddy. Injuries forced manager Larry Durker to start Darryl Ward and Lance Berkman along with...
About that, gotta clean that up if I could.
National League, here's Sammy at the plate of Darren Dreyfuss. Get out of town, and he means it. It's his 54th. 11th home run in his last 15 games at a 1-0 lead. Kyle Farnsworth going for the complete game shutout. He gets Todd Hollinsworth to fly out to Sammy and Wright to end it. Farnsworth finishes with a two-hitter as the Cubs win by a score of... The Brewers and the Padres, top of the sixth, two down. Buddy Carlisle making his major league debut at a no-hitter through 5 2/3. And Chris Gomez misplayed the grounder there. The inning continues. He walked Ron Belliard, and Jeff Jenkins takes him deep, breaking up the no-hitter in a big way with a three-run bomb. The Brewers lead 3-2. Bottom 10, here we go, tied at four. Bases loaded for Dave Magadan. Magadan, line to Grissom. Here's Phil Nevin tagging from third. Watch this. He takes out the home plate umpire, Jeff Nelson on the slide. Nevin missed the plate, dives back, and able to score the winning run. And the Padres win in dramatic fashion. Garrett Anderson facing Bartolo Colon. Fastball up and out. Anderson is 18th of the year to tie it at four. One of three homers given up by Colon on the night, who actually pitched well. Bottom of the seventh, tied at five. Roberto Alomar sends one deep. Would it go out? No, Park could hold it. Omar Vizquel comes around to score on the double. Indians take a 6-5 lead. And how many times you see it? Guy hits a double off the wall. He makes a great play at second base. There's Robbie flashing the leather and the throw, robbing Jeff Houston. The Indians win 7-5. 51 of Colon's first for the White Sox. Maglio Ordonez tries to field the ball, slips and falls. A couple of runs scored. More trouble on the outfield for the Sox. Carlos Lee slams into the wall. Couldn't make the catch. He was okay. Jesus Pena strikes out Edgar Martinez, except you still need three outs before you can head to the dugout. His teammates got a good laugh at that one. No laughing matter in the eighth. The base is loaded. Martinez, his fourth career grand slam, 20th of the year, and the Mariners go on to win 14-6. Edgar had
place in the central, top of the first. Edgardo Alfonso with a rip on Shane Reynolds. Drive that one deep, driving it out. Solo shot is 21st of the year. Mets up on top, 1-0. Top of the second, it's 3-0 Mets. Alfonso rips that one, base hit. He'd have that batting average up to .319 by the end of the night. Alfonso 2-for-2. Top of the fourth, it's 7-0 Mets. One on for Edgardo Alfonso, and he drives this one. That's deep. That's gone. Two-run shot off Brian Williams is 22nd. 22 home runs, new Met record for second baseman. Better than Felix Mion, Steve. How about that? How about this? 10-0 Mets. Alfonso gone again. Third home run of the game. 11-0 Mets. He's 4-for-4. Top of the eighth. Here we go. Looking for that fourth home run. That's not going to do it. Line drive, base hit. Mike Schmidt among the 12 who have four, by the way. 5-for-5 for Alfonso. And you know what? Top of the ninth. He gets another shot at it. So many runs being scored. Alfonso, another chance. hits that one hard, rips, but it's not flying out. Ground rule double. But six for six for Alfonso, first Met in history to do so. Not even Wayne Garrett got that. 17 to 1 the final. 54 home runs going into this game. Got a good piece of that. It is high. It is no go foul. Very next pitch. Matt Clement got him. Pitcher's duel scoreless to the sixth inning. Tied at four in the seventh. Kilvio Veras on second. Rick Aguilera, wild pitch, gets through Veras to third. Reed trying to catch him, leaving home. Throw coming in. No, why? Now he's going to go back. Now he's going to score. Yes, Padres win this one 8-4. Padres taking four.
Got a great arm in the outfield. Maybe the best in baseball. Pick it up. Bottom of the eighth, runners in the corners for Greg Colburn. Fly to shallow right. Here's Vlad. The throw. Steve Finley going to test him, and Finley beats the throw. And Guerrero is upset with himself. The Diamondbacks do win by a score of 5-4. How about the rookie, Rob Ryan? Bottom 10, tied at four, man on for Barry Bonds. Get out of town, and I mean it. It's a game winner. A two-run shot, second of the night. The Giants win 6-4, 28 homers for Bonds on the season. He has 12 homers in his last Sky Dome. Tough to stay in a wild card race that way. Bottom of the first, Shannon Stewart at the plate. Stewart lines out to Corey Koski. Stewart 0 for 4, his hitting streak over at 26 games. Bottom of the second, Tony Bautista at the plate, who just had a 1-0 lead. Now it's 2-0 off the foul pole. Of course, it's a fair ball off Jason Ryan there, 21st for Bautista. Top of the ninth, 2-1, man on. Matt Lawton grounds to Homer Bush. The dive and the throw, nice play there, and Toronto goes on to win by a score of 2-1. The Blue Jays, four back in 500 for the season against Kansas City, against Ray Holbert in only his 16th game this season. That's just not fair. Can you say mismatch? A sign of things to come for KC. Bottom two, game tied at one. Jose Offerman up with two outs. Base hit up the middle of Jeff Suppan, the former Red Sox. Carlos Beltran, strong throw to the plate. Jason Varitek in there. Offerman had four hits. Sox go up 2-1. Pedro against Holbert again. Same deal. Six strikeouts through three innings for Martinez. Bottom five, Sox up 4-1. Hey, Butch Husky, nice pickup. And he picks one up and drops it in the right field. Brian Daubach and Nomar Garcia-Para come in to score. Red Sox go up 6-1. Top six, Martinez facing Holbert again a third time. Got a feel for the kid. Martinez strikes him out a third time. Red Sox go on to win. Tori, but watch this. Who says the Bronx Bombers don't have a sense of humor? They fake him out. And Bernie Williams would come out with his ring. And Rain shares a moment with his former mates. A's up 2-0. Top of the fifth, Matt Stairs with the bases loaded off Hideki Arabu. Rich Becker and Randy Velarde, the former Yank, come around to score. That's kind of redundant, former Yank. I mean, who is it, a former Yank? Yanks respond. Bottom five, two on for Chuck Knobloch. Had himself a ball game off the impressive Tim Hudson. Three-run shot. Yanks within one. It's 4-3. Bottom seven, Randy Velarde showing off the defense. Diving stop on Luis Sol's grounder and the throw to get him. Bottom of the eighth, tied at four. Jason Isringhausen took the subway to the Bronx, facing Jorge Posada on a 3-0 pitch. He walks Posada. Art Howe couldn't believe it. That forces in a run as Bernie Williams scores. The Yanks go up 5-4. Here's Pudge in a scoreless game, top of the fourth, and Brian Moeller gets him to ground in the 6-4-3 double play as one of Pudge's three grounders to short. Same inning, two on now for Roth. He's red hot, we told you. Moeller gets him to fly out to left to end the threat. Palmeiro went 0-3, put the triple crown on hold. Moeller pitching a gem. Bottom seven, Gabe Kapler breaks the scoreless tie. Get out of town. He didn't really mean it because it just got over the wall. His 15th of the year, but that's all the Tigers need. They go on to win 1-0. Moeller a three-hitter. It's his first win